We also have, as we mentioned before, this generation is very low.
Wait, this is each one of a string of Rolfsen.
Yes. Yes, yeah, that, yes. The generators of the complement. Yeah. Okay. So, we can express every element here in the complement of the surface as a linear combination of the bases. Let's call it like this. These coefficients. The linking number is an offset.
Yes, the trouble is from this formula.
Yeah.
If you just yes, can you use it from this formula?
Coefficients, and we can also, like we mentioned before, we can see this homology as a lambda, which means that when that means whenever we have this, it's going to be.
This equality. So I thought that this equality lies in the H children, in the S children, and that visualizes in S. What is it? And so
this
I truly don't understand something. I don't know what exactly. So you connect by G on the elements of H. H1 of X children.
Yes.
And A.
Yeah, that was correct. That was correct.
Yes.
H2, like, but this picture
okay.
not related.
Yes.
This is a picture.
Yes.
You can draw the schematic picture on the universal cover or intensive cover. Yes?
Yeah. I think that.
I mean, universal again? These are going to be copies, like, and so. How we glue them, so they have this. Here are our ends. This is going to be. By introducing this NIs, which is going to be N0 and N1, we are gluing the negative, we are identifying the negative part of the, okay, negative part of this one with the positive part of the new one. So this is how we get something path connected, and this is our covering, and I forgot the question. Why was I doing this?
Because you wanted to explain this quality.
So the premise is that X children is the union of Y hat.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
And why did you need N?
Because, so here in this part, you have like with the same index. Positive and negative, but you need to glue them with the previous ones. So these n relations, which are homomorphisms, it's how you glue them to the next copy or the previous one.
So you glue it along m.
Along m.
And I still don't get it. Why do you need n? Because this n and plus and minus. So how is it x in the construction?
So, okay, here I'm gluing N1 positive to the copy of Y0, and the one is staying in the same, with the same index.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So it's just how you identify these two guys.
So
it's like, yeah?
The construction of the universal cover, of this universal given cover, doesn't need to mention n less than 10 minus n i's. But if you want a I minus, yes, a I minus leaves in n I minus.
Yeah.
So maybe that can help to see a I minus. Okay.
So, and y minus and the x tilde should have y one equals to what? To some finite thing?
The commutator subgroup of y one of x.
Hmm?
It equals the commutator subgroup of
yes.
y one of x, but we will not need it.
Thank you. Maybe, and H1 is just 0.
H1 is something that you want.
Yeah, yeah, this is the idea. This is what we want. Okay.
So for about this equality, this, so we have this AI sits somewhere in this boundary, yes?
Yes.
So this AI, so it is the lift of AI?
Yes, this is some lift of
so this AI doesn't have anything to do with this I, yeah? So this I is from 1 to 2G, and this I is just Z, yeah?
Oh, yeah, okay, let's use the difference. They are not the same.
Yeah, that's
okay, sorry, this is yes, a very good mark. So yes, and this is some lift AI field, yes, some fixed lift, and or maybe I should put some A and J, yes, how to do it. And there is AI J plus 1 here, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Y has in this J, yes, so 0, 1, I, 0, 1, and J, okay, yeah. Okay.
Yes. Let's call this exchange. Or maybe okay. How about this? Let us fix one of them and call them A I cube.
Okay.
And this one will be called T A I cube. Yes,
okay.
Because this is called this current transformation axis. But also we have the two shows. Yes. So here is A I cube. Plus or which is blue? Plus or minus?
Minus.
And this one is here we have
a plus.
I use the plus.
Here are the YJs. In the top, in the bottom right, we have YJs.
So it looks, it seems that the relation is not quite like that. So the relation is that this one equals this because there are homologous in the universal cover. But then we also have a T A I cube which lives here.
So it should be a I minus equals to T A I plus 1 plus something like this. So it should be plus minus 1 or in the sub.
Here, yeah.
Well, this was, as you remember, this I was among finite remaining generators of the homologous transference. It's different.
Yes. So it should be correct, yes? Underlined the board.
Yeah.
Okay. This picture, which I tried to draw here, is not quite correct. So this is one chordgen of Y, and in this chordgen we have AI minus and AI plus. So in the complement of the loop, they were close to each other. But now we cut the complement of the loop along the Zephyr surface. And they become, are on the opposite side of this picture, because this is one quarter of the Zephyr surface and this is another quarter. Just below the Zephyr surface goes here and above goes here. This works.
They differ by the action of T.
Yes, and they differ by the action of T, or maybe more precisely, this AI.
So should they kill them in the box?
Yes, maybe this should be T. It's the leaf, some leaves. And so this can be
And the bottom index is the number of vector of base, or is the number of...
Yes, it's the...
And, but T is shift the y0 to y1, there is some other lower indices. So I see there are base on each cut pieces AY, A2, and so on. This is one index. And the second index is just the number of cycles. In this formula, T has to be changed. Number of cycle is preserved, I see, from this picture. Yes, T acts to a cycle, and on the left side we have the same index I. It is possible, this is a property of base vector.
It can be written for any cycle on the Zephyr surface, but not necessarily for
base. But this is not geometrically T switch the lower indices. Each cycle equipped with two indices, the number of base vector and the number of the domain.
Yes. In each copy of Y, we have a copy of AI.
So we in this formula we omit this lower indices because obviously I equal to A plus one when T acts. Yes.
So this tilde means that we choose one specific leaf, and then when we write T here, it means that we choose the next leaf.
Yeah, and choose any integer number.
So
and yes, okay, and even and don't write it. And by this leaf, we bring the leaf to the gate. This the gate puzzle in this infinite strip.
Of course, we can choose just invariant with respect to T, but the geometry of the cycle on the Zephyr surface would be changed a lot. So lower index is not a number of vector of base, because if
it goes from A4,
but why the T shift? Maps I to I. I see cycle because plus and minus, yes?
Yes, because of the plus mm-hmm. and minus.
Let me try to explain again.
Yeah. Probably I see, yes.
So we start with A I plus tilde. It is here. So it is some lift of A I plus.
Mm-hmm.
Now we apply T, it means that we move to the next copy.
Mm-hmm.
But here, this
you can replace plus into minus.
This minus, and this minus lives in the same copy, so it's the same index I.
Yes,
it's the same tilde. So okay. So tilde then means that we consider it in this specific copy, zero because one. Okay. Y is zero.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have this equality. Yes?
Yes, because in this lemma we have only a without plus and minus, and here we have a plus and a minus, two collection of cycles.
Yes, so here we could to make it clearer, we could write just a, where a is any cycle or the cipher surface.
So since it is any cycle, we can express it again as a linear combination of linear numbers, this A with alpha J.
That's alpha J.
Alpha J.
Let me explain this. For them, maybe we still not clear to someone. We can, so we any cycle alpha can be written as a linear combination of alpha j's because they are bases. Now we just apply linking number to both sides, and we get linking number with alpha j, linking number of alpha j equals the sum of c j into number. Some index. Okay, this can be I. Then it's alpha J alpha I. Now this is the Kronecker delta index. So this equals CI times it just equals CI. The linking number.
Yeah.
It's equals to delta IJ.
I don't know.
Yeah, this.
This is not quite delta j because this was ai alpha
and
j.
Alpha j, yes.
Okay, so here we have alpha. So sorry, we should. Yes, and this was not quite right. Yes, this was.
It
should be. A.
Yes, it's A.
And what is it?
Yes.
So this should be A.
A and alpha lives in different homology group, and this looks not very nice.
Yes, but the linking number between them is defined, and the linking number between alpha and alpha is not defined. We don't want self-linking. So we can go on.
Yeah.
But then here this linear combination.
Linear combination of alpha,
yes.
Is A. I think this is different.
Yes.
A is a cycle on the surface, Zeffert surface, and alpha is a cycle in the space.
Yeah,
or not.
This is weird now.
Where? In what form?
So it was alpha.
Yes.
What was
alpha, it was all alpha instead.
this is better. Let's try. So the link number of yes, now we apply it here, a alpha and theta. Okay, now this is delta.
Delta AG.
This alpha. Alpha J. Alpha J.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is delta, so this is CG. And this is what we want. CI.
Yeah.
This is CI.
Okay. But, okay. So this basically we'll say that the linking form is not degenerate and we take the dual basis. With respect to
yes.
It's not generated by the new form, you would change the new basis, which with respect to this value.
So alpha is some kind of universal cycle. If you take linking number with this universal cycle on arbitrary vector of base on the surface, we just have the coefficient Cj which attached to this cycle.
Yes.
Are we proving out anything?
We are proving the theorem.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this equality is supposed to give us the relations in the Alexander module. So this was the linking number of alpha, this AJ. Yes, how do you use this? So we have this table which we proved. Now you want to use it. Yes? How do you use it?
Well, but with the essence of the law, the truth again, I'm sorry. So, is this a quality where down on base, or to help choose somewhere?
This should be A, now the relationship will be good.
And the first argument is what? A tilde the minus?
A tilde the minus, yeah.
With A tilde. So they are again.
But maybe just a minus.
But I mean, if you want chi, then you have 10.
Why is that the two?
I would be. It would be clear if we describe the action of T of very of basic cycle, but not of the linear combination of basic cycles. What form? We have T acts on complicated cycle. I think on the right hand side, we just has to have some linking number, and on the right side we have basic cycle, not why?
Yes, it should be basic. Your number erased this.
Yes, that way.
So it should be here also. Yes.
But the statement is the statement is meaningless. There is no, yeah, because the plus is defined only for basis. Yeah, so plus and minus is defined only for basis.
No, it is defined for any
for
any cycle of
central. So it was still true even without the ice.
Yes. If just want to use it was true without ice, but now we want to use it and apply it to the basis cycles.
Mm-hmm.
So this formula which we want to use, this one, is in S3 or where is this?
Yeah, I don't know, because there's a T here. If you have T, then it should be up on the S. But alpha
yeah, that's what we have the tension here.
Yeah,
like we picked this.
If you want that children in the second argument of the linking number, so there is linking alpha tilde I, comma alpha, comma aj with children.
Oh,
yeah. And alpha lives again on the base, not the common space.
Yeah, okay. So this formula, this lambda was in H1 of S3 minus L.
Yeah, that's fine.
And here we have copies of S3 minus L. This was called Y, this complement was also called Y, and we have copies Y0, Y1, and so on. So I think we are using this in the copies.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's fine. I just feel uncomfortable with not seeing
a tilde here.
Tilde above all the letters. Above the alpha j. For example, you want to have tilde above alpha j, yes or not? In this, to the left of the equality sign, yeah, right here, you want tilde above alpha j, yes. I mean, otherwise it was.
Yeah. Okay.
And also on the previous letter, here above this letter, you want also actually yes, but you want them everywhere.
This is not so clear because. For the center surface, we have two leaves. So this Y, this Y has sort of one bound in the bottom because these two sides are good together, and we can talk about the J's in this L. But in this copy, why I have a bond that consists of two copies of that. So there is some problem here.
Solution to this problem.
Well, I think yes. So this, we should have tilde here.
Yes.
And we don't need any tilde here because these are just numbers, and we can compute them
by
looking in the string minus seven.
In this form, I'm fine with this. That's perfectly fine. I mean, at least the logical side. The logical side.
This not makes sense.
Yeah, this is.
Okay, so here, this is just computing things. This is the leading number of aj calls. So,
which is vij.
Yes. And this is J-I, yeah. Okay. So, sorry, that's equal. Divide it by this. J-I-J minus J-I. These are exactly the Seifert matrices. And this is a transpose.
Yes, so we get this.
Multiplied
by the vector of ways of surfaces.
Yeah.
So this is a presentation matrix.
Yes, exactly.
So we have the as generators of our module, we have this alpha j tilde. For S3 minus M, we have alpha 1, alpha 2, and so on, up to alpha 2 j. Then we pick their lifts into some fixed lift by 0 of 1. Fixed copy by 0 of 1. So they all live here. And these are the generators of this module, homology of this infinite cyclic column. And the relations are just this, and they can be written in this matrix form. So this is the presentation matrix.
Yeah, okay. So we get this one.
What are all other relations?
Good question. Another good question is why there are no other generators.
Yes.
Could you explain why this expression is the relation? I can understand. We have a scalar product of two vectors. What does it mean? Alpha multiplied by V. V is a vector or what?
V is a number.
It's just the linking number.
Yes. V and J is an integer, and V and J T is an element of lambda.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
We have a product of element of lambda with a cycle on the covering. Alpha
yes.
Tilde is a cycle on the covering.
Yes.
And this means that this is indeed the relation. I see.
Yeah.
Yes, it's a good question why there are no other generators and no other relations. I think one way to do this would be to write the arbitrary sequence for example, as one part, we take sequence versions of this surface, the union of all of them. The other part is the union of this open y bias. And just do the wire reverse sequence over lambda. And this is a way to check what you mean by over lambda. It means that each term of the Meyer-Riedler sequence will be a lambda module, and the homomorphisms will be also lambda
homomorphisms. Is also true.
Even odd, what Meyer-Riedler sequence?
This green could be one. In the Meyer-Riedler sequence, we need two spaces which have a non-empty intersection. One space could be this green part. And another space that would be just this everything except for this white surfaces, the component of this white surfaces.
With respect to T action, T equivalent.
T equivalent, yes. The Meyer-Riedler sequence would be T equivalent.
Mm-hmm.
And we can just do the computation and see that there are no other generators and relations. This is a method which Denis tried to do last time. But it is a little bit complicated. And there is an alternative method not to use Meyer-Riedler sequence, just to do it geometrically. So if you have a cycle here, we just need to show that it is a sum of, it is expressible in terms of this generator. But this is clear. We have these surfaces and we have our cycle. The surfaces are connected. So if the surface intersects the cycle, it has to intersect it in some even number of points, algebraically zero number of points, and we can pick some arcs in the surface to connect this intersection points. And this splits our cycle into a sum of cycles which sit in separate columns.
Not canonically, because the path would be...
Not canonically, but we want to show that this generator suffice.
Mm-hmm.
So once we split our cycle into a sum of cycles in this copies of y, then in each copy of y, we know that alpha i's are generators.
Mm-hmm.
So we have generators in one copy of y zero, but in all other copies of y, we have their translates like this t squared, t cubed, or t minus one. Then this gives us also generators there. So every cycle, so these are generators, no other.
Mm-hmm.
About relations, it should be similar. So if you have a relation,
basically, what is the relation? It is a two cycle. A two chain.
It is a two chain. Yes.
Yes.
So there's some surface which you can similarly cut by these surfaces. This is not so obvious, so maybe we can leave this in the exercise.
Mm-hmm.
It should be possible to do it this way.
Mm-hmm. And it also theoretically should check that this is indeed the given color, must not be the color here. So
this is a my construction is the universal cyclic coloring.
Mm-hmm.
The infinite cyclic coloring, so. We have, we know the homology of S3 minus K. This is Z.
Mm-hmm.
So it's universal abelian covering is just the infinite secret covering.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay.
Plus in this formula means transposition on what? V plus
T.
it's transposition.
Not transposition, but translation.
No.
Oh,
transposition.
No,
transposition.
Transposition.
Okay.
So, now we are done. Okay.
Okay, we do an example for notes for this theorem, and then we'll break. Okay?
Okay. I don't remember how it was. How Rolfsen chose it.
But maybe you just do it again because not all people were present.
Okay. Let's see. We have the sharp.
I suggest that we just compute the ciphered matrix, for example, and then we can say that according to the theorem, this gives us the representation of the tangent module.
Okay.
So we need to draw some ciphered surface.
Yeah. Okay, I'll draw the surface and then I'll try it. Yeah. Okay, so we have the
what is G?
G what?
What? G equals to what?
The genus of the
surface. Genus of the surface, yeah.
Yes. And what is it?
In this one,
yes,
for the trapoid.
Yeah.
It's one. We have a torus, the punctured torus.
Okay.
Here. Yeah. Okay. So if it wants to be positive and the other one to be negative, we also have the
relation functions.
Oh yeah, it's bigger. Okay. Yeah. We have our generators here.
So these are A1 and A2, yes?
Yes. So let's call it A1, A2. These are going to be should I looking at another picture for the plus.
What is M1 plus?
It's the we're
it's a push up.
Push up, yeah. Push up of A in the direction of in the positive direction in the B corner. Yeah, so
okay.
It's like going here in positive, it's going like this. I was trying to draw it here separately with another surface so we can see the linking number easily and write down the metrics in easier way. But then here, from here it will be here.
Maybe you can draw a bigger picture then.
Yes. Okay. I guess I will start with bigger pictures next time. Should I like show the process? Maybe.
Maybe you could, they are, this green ones are on the surface, yes?
Yes, they are on
the surface. So here you can show,
also show the
load, yes?
Yeah, in the now A1 plus will be push a key here.
This one.
Yeah, it's above this.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and here it goes below. Yeah.
Yeah.
To plus or the
looks right.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so now the matrix, will be here it was A and A plus.
Maybe you can remind the formula, which you don't like.
Oh yeah, okay, so my entries are J plus. So here's A1 and A2 plus. This is minus 1. A2, A1 plus is 0. Okay, let me see. A2, A2 plus is
Here you can just go zero. Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
it's zero over here. Yeah. It's below both of them. Yeah. Mm.
Well, you get all down, right? So just write.
Yeah, I'm just trying to know why I got to zeros here. I mean, I'm trying to find a mistake.
this white one is not linear.
Yeah, I think the one, yeah, the A1 plus is not correct, perhaps, yeah. Because it's not linked to A1. Oh, let's see. Maybe I did something wrong here. Transpose it.
Yes, let us write it down. This is going to be the agenda for a moment now.
Exactly. Or should I leave it just like it's up? Okay.
Questions?
I think that was.
So we computed the algebraic polynomial of the tree form using this theorem, which you proved.
And Alessandro Matris, why we take the determinant I can.
Yeah, it's a good question. For knots, we can just define the Alexander polynomial as the determinant of the Alexander matrix.
And we have to prove that the determinant is well defined. So we have to take some stabilization of Alexander matrix.
It is well defined up to units of the group ring.
Yes.
But if it is well defined, what form we take the determinant? We have to take the matrix itself.
Yes, it is a stronger invariant. I think there exist knots which have the same Alexander polynomial but different Alexander.
So
polynomial.
This matrix is well defined up to change of the basis. Yes, and the determinant is well defined. Absolutely.
What do you mean by saying that the matrix is invariant? The matrix is
the module. The module, Alexander module, is an invariant of the knot,
but not the matrix.
Yes, the matrix depends on the choice of the basis. So if you change the basis, the matrix changes in the usual way.
Mm-hmm. And the matrix with respect to this gauge is called Alexander model. Yes.
You can this way, but you can also say that the Alexander module is just a homology. It's another infinite cyclic cover as a non-homology. Some people have a different notation. They take relative homology minus the inverse of a point. So P is a covering cover. So there is a little difference between this group and this module, but it is not big. So just for terminology, some people call this the Alexander module, and other people call this the
Alexander module. But the collection of points did no contribution to the first homology.
One point, you choose one point. This is one point.
You take just a base like a Leander model. Alexander model can be considered not only up to permutation of cycle, but up to translation of the cyclic covering. And this depends on the choice of a point. So you take T can multiply by T. Yes,
Here you don't have any point. This is also good. Yes, it is a down the model. So down is Z of T as minus 1. So T acts here by governing translations.
I take H, why H depends on the point? Because I have take a base on the T model, yes, and if I take multiply by T, then
you mean this point?
Yes.
It's just a question of terminology. These two modules are closely related. It's like this one has additional lambda free subnet.
The other one.
I don't remember. Yes. So they essentially differ by one copy of lambda. So it's not a big difference. You have the exact sequence of pair, yes? So this is
приведенная гомология, reducing гомология, and this is not reducible.
Yes. Okay, so let us make a break, and after a break we will look at two concurrent links, a couple of examples. So we have this
two components, right? This part is the triangle and this one is the configurational. So we want to construct again the abelian covering for it. Ooh. So the complement of this knot looks like, I don't know. So basically we have like these two dimensional space times 0, 1, and like in one direction we will have many copies of
wait this is something you have to construct.
Yes,
this is, don't tell us the answer.
Okay. So, well, okay, this is just, okay. Is it hard? Okay, so the complement of the triangle looks like where the triangle is here, and it's like I don't know how to draw this.
Let me try to draw this.
Yeah.
It's
like here. And it's somewhere here, it's like.
You assume that we know the definition of Alexander module Alexander polynomial in the case of limit of link, yes?
Not true. So we have x which is the complement to the knot. We have to the link now. We have x2 which is the universal abelian cover. Okay.
Universal abelian cover means what? Because L is two component. Z plus Z. Cover, yes?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. And we have the one dimensional cohomology. We could also do module the pretty much of a point, but let us not do it. Let's just look at this as simple. So this is a lambda module. Where lambda is that of moment for which variables x, y,
yeah.
Okay, so this is the Alexander module for our purposes, and we just want to understand it, like find the presentation. For the Alexander polynomial, let us not. It is a little bit complicated. Well, let us discuss it next time.
So we don't know we assume only Alexander model, and what's the purpose of this examination? We will give calculation of Alexander model of what?
The purpose of everything which so for the Alexander polynomial of the Alexander module, the Alexander polynomial of knots are quite well understood and are quite easy from some people. Maybe there are some things which are difficult, but we have seen how to write a presentation, yes, in terms of Seifert matrix.
No, for link, for knot, I understood because we just spent.
Yes.
And for link,
so
I have
now the question is about links.
Yes.
And this question turns out to be not so easy.
Mm-hmm.
So, in general, for arbitrary link, there is no such a simple clear formula for the presentation of the Alexander module. There are some there is some way to construct a presentation which I hope Monica will tell us next time in March. General approach. And today we just look at two or three specific examples where we can do this computation, where we can write a presentation of the Alexandra module, because the link is simple enough.
We were looking for Alexandra module representation. Just we take the lambda polynomial Laurent mean of two variables, and we will introduce some relations. Yes. This is polynomial of t variable x and y. Yes, relation.
Yes.
Only one relation, or there are few.
We will see.
Mm-hmm.
We have some lambda module which we want to describe. But first
the potential matrix will not be square.
We will see.
Okay.
I think it will be. We'll see. So, the picture, let's draw the picture of the trifold, yes? Okay, now. So this is a cylinder with a knotted hole. Those are the knotted hole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is what you wanted to draw, yes?
Well, I guess I shall do it also for this one, but. It's a bit complicated. Yeah, so we want to so we want to compute this. So maybe we can start with the complement of the Hopf field. Uh-huh.
Can we?
Which is
like this, but without knots.
Yes. It is. Here we have, they're not knotted, but we have then
our next goal? Do we show the next surface?
No. So we want to construct okay. First, to understand the complement of the knot of the link. Sorry. Then.
In which terms?
I guess here we have z, the free model over z x y z on this example, not more complicated. This is not the most simple example. Is unlinked to unlinked.
This one.
What's the answer?
Well,
for this.
Just free
z x y model, yes?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Zero.
Reduced and non-reduced. Reduced model, I think, cannot zero because zero.
Okay, Monica, so we drew some pictures of what is for a hoop link, for example. Yes.
Yeah, for trivial link, there are many cycles in the covering because this cycle goes like organized like a cycle on the toric lattice into R3. And we have just very long of cycle. This is free model, but reduced. Is trivial like this. Reduced model, reduced homology.
So here in this picture, there is a torus which sits between these two components. Yes?
Yes.
Embedded, yes. And the complement is actually just a thickening of this torus. Mm-hmm. Yes, X is homomorphic to S1 times S1 times R.
Yes.
Yep.
So what is X tilde?
X tilde is R cross R.
R. Yeah, R cross R.
So empty.
Yes. So what is H1 of X tilde?
I guess tilde.
Yes, it is zero.
Yeah.
But we are interested in this slightly more interesting example, yes, with two knots. So we want to understand the complement. This complement in the case of two knots.
Okay.
I think it is obtained from this one.
Yeah.
Yes? In which way?
But this upper corridor is just like you take a point on the torus and just project it along.
Okay. Maybe I can try to think about this one first with the threshold.
How about one see the upper homomorphism? The upper group
when you think of a circle and a line in the middle of it.
Yeah.
I think.
Okay.
Then you have these torus and the
depth
of projection. A sphere without this link is the same as R3 without this circle and this line.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, sorry.
So now we want to perform some surgery on this thing and to obtain
what is the answer, Monica? Could you algebraically?
Oh, okay. You want to move straight to the point. Well, it's we put this index just to say how many components. Okay, and it's quotient by the of the center polynomials. Yeah, I'm writing.
You have x and y, Larry.
Yeah.
You have not.
Yes, yeah, yeah, x and y. So we have x, and the other one is the Alexander polynomial, the figure right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, y.
But it is a happy coincidence, yes.
Hmm?
But it is a happy coincidence that it's just the real sum. I mean, in general, you don't.
In general, yeah.
Right, probably for Bohr and error.
Yeah, but you can
get something more.
Okay.
Yes, in general, it can be more complicated.
Complicated, yes.
In this case, this the result of a computation which we wanted to see.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Torus still exists on this picture if we go out, if Trefor not will be inside the torus, and this is just the same, just 8 not is inside the torus, so torus exists, and then in this torus we have some such yes of this like this picture.
So should I draw?
Yes.
So we first draw this six points. And so this is the surface of this thick torus. Inside of it, it has a hole.
Yeah.
First, draw the complement of this link. We take this second torus and we glue this picture to it. So, this picture is this side surface of the cylinder. And we also choose here. We just choose an annulus here like this, and we to this annulus we go this annulus. So we take the union of this not at all, but let me call it somehow H, yes. And we have this sick torus T.
This T torus is which torus?
This.
And what I'm going to tell the complement to this, yes?
Yes.
We have a solid torus without interior. Yes, here.
We have a solid torus without a small tube.
Okay, and what does it mean? Annulus, annulus this like this. Yes, this is small.
On the surface of this torus, on the exterior surface. Mm-hmm. Yes, we take this green annulus. Mm-hmm. Let us call it A, this green annulus, mm-hmm. And we also have this side surface in color. Yeah. So I think you should rotate this picture a little bit so that this knot is clearly inside here, and then you can see that this union is precisely the complement of this one.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
A and A is S one times I.
But well, the end pieces of this not whole. We should do something with them, no?
They just, we just use them like this, so it gets, so here...
Oh, it's outside of the, well, this hole is not, okay.
I can draw this red twofold in this picture. So here it just goes like this.
Mm-hmm.
This white one is inside in this tube. And here it goes like this. In the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And then it goes. Okay.
And then we need to change the perspective and glue the.
Yes, now the question is about this one.
This one, yeah.
So maybe somebody else can explain.
Can we before show the answer? Just the first term. In this formula, you take just this without the second, yes? Without the second portion.
Yeah.
Lambda here. Lambda 2, yes?
Yeah.
This is the answer. For this. For this, okay.
Yes.
How can we see this? What is the x tilde for? Can you see x tilde for this case?
It looks like
this is the picture you were drawing in the beginning.
Yes. It's like you have R and here you have R and the I here, and here you have the copies of the complement of the church.
So maybe this can be written more precisely as R2 cross R. Maybe this can be called TT now. T and this is TT. Now this is tilde, we also want to do something. Yes, because we have this union, this is this. If we have x tilde, this tilde union.
Otherwise, the answer is at zero.
Huh?
Otherwise, the answer is at zero, isn't it? So?
Yes.
Tilde union is what? I don't understand. What's
the question?
Yeah. Yes.
With something which have homology like the first term.
Yes.
S model f over lambda x, the homology of something is just the first term of this formula. Okay. I think we just see such a picture, just a cyclic cover over the torus, yes, or over the algebraically it's go well, but yeah. Geometrically not quite clear now.
Yes.
Okay, a little hint. If I look at what happens here, here I have 18. Maybe I can draw 18.
It's indeed, it is R times R.
Yeah.
No, yeah, it's this I is a piece of S1, which we
yes, M1.
So it's
should be.
No, I mean that, well, a tilde is this horizontal R.
Uh-huh.
Well, the several of these streets.
Counting
this and then this and this, yeah.
Yes, so.
And you want to lose, release.
Maybe. So this was not. So in this picture, this green animal is in the boundary of this torus. So yes. somehow this became.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. There is a complement, but also there is exterior, which means that we remove the interior of a tubular neighborhood of L.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so it's more convenient maybe to understand the exterior. Yes, we remove the interior of the tubular neighborhood. And then we can write this. Yes?
But this eye and that eye are different eyes.
What one is a green eye?
Yeah, green eye is different. Green eye is 0, 1. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
From different R. So now, inside of this, here we have A, our angle is A, which is.
S1 times
maybe some let us call it J, some part J, which sits in S1. And times
1.
And here we have J tilde, which is the union of, or I can write the Jewish union of
J sits at the torus.
J sits in the circle, it's an arc in the circle.
Ah, okay.
Great.
Yeah. It is, yeah. One geranium of the torus.
Yes. So here we have R. J. Times one. And what is J I? Well, in the universal cover of the circle, so we can the circle is the sort of G. In the universal cover of the circle, which is one, one, we have main copies of this G. So we can call them G0, G1, and so on. G minus 1. These are G I and the unions are from negative infinity to infinity.
Probably yes, but I have an alternative idea. Can I say?
Sure, sure.
My idea is to take the subcovering, cyclic subcovering, just like in the previous. Let take out this trivial ring and take just a cyclic subcovering of the first one. Then the problem is take the second. We just investigated. And then we take the double cyclic covering, but it is look like a tube unlimited in very long z lambda x model, and so this give no contribution, just the second term, because this very long tube is trivial. All this T action was on the first example. Not good.
But as you can see from the answer, we have contribution from both nodes.
For both nodes is this the next problem. I try to understand this picture is trivial not. And if this picture is trivial not, can be reduced to our previous problem we have discussed.
Dr. Mikhailovich, maybe if you draw the blackboard, we will understand what you mean.
I'm not sure you. I will. The idea is clear. Take cyclic covering over this link. This cyclic covering was discussed previously, and then in this cyclic covering we know everything, because this is just a lambda x model, and then take the twice cyclic covering and let try to prove that nothing will be happens. Just
actually we'll use your idea in the next example. But mm-hmm. Here I think it is possible to draw it, but we can do without it, just mm-hmm. direct, because you can see that.
So and GI, could you repeat? GI is just the picture.
So GI are lifts of this RJ to R1. The RJ sits in the circle. And in the universal cover of the circle, it has several lifts.
This is square. What this is segment?
Segment. But when you multiply it with R, it becomes a strip.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So this is what Monica was drawing here. So as I understand this picture, so this is a plane, and this segment minus one. Yes, but we can look at the at just what this one. Yes. So maybe the okay. Suppose that this segment goes away. So we have outer surface. So here we have just this. This is G zero. So this is G1, and so on. And then we multiply by R, and we have such strips. Yes, so the union of these strips is A2.
This is Z plus Z cover, the picture of Z plus Z cover, how X to the generator
one that acts in this direction and another acts in this direction.
Which is which corresponds to the knotted the knotted the vertical, yes? Vertical is knotted.
Yeah. It depends on what you mean.
On this picture we have two generators, one is knotted and the second is unknotted.
Yes, but which is so X and Y, yes, you can draw
the X and Y. No, in this picture, in simple picture, not at the difficult, at the previous one.
It is difficult to answer your question because it depends on how you select X and Y in this picture. There are different ways to understand your question.
But on that picture, in this picture.
Sir, in this picture, yes.
Can you put x first and y second? X.
Okay, x. This is x.
Yes.
And this is y.
Can I ask you about can you explain?
So then here we have this is x, yes.
Mm-hmm.
This is y.
Mm-hmm. And on that picture?
Then, of course, here this is Y and this is X.
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And now we just glue the cyclic color that we already have.
Exactly. So we have. Over H, we have H cubed, infinite secret cover, which we studied before the break.
Mm-hmm.
And we glue a copy of H cubed to H cubed.
Yes. This is just what I tried to explain on the blackboard, but now you just helped me.
Yes.
This is my wish to make such an explication, okay?
Okay, so we understood this example, right? Is everyone okay with
sorry,
this?
Sorry, it will be...
Yes.
Yeah.
But why, if you want to compute the answer... Yes, so okay, let me say, so the homology of this... the homology of this can be written as there is no homology for this plane, yes, and for sick plane also, but each copy of H tilde gives us some contribution. So it is the sum of H of H tilde y. Yes, for each strip we have a copy of H tilde from negative infinity to infinity, but these are. Maybe I can write T. I don't know. It's X should be here. So this one of them was what one of the that of Y modular Y. So I think this was. We mixed this variables. So then this one sum of this set of x. Plus minus 1 modular x squared minus x plus 1. And now we want to take so this becomes the sum. I think we should okay, y to the power of I plus I from negative infinity to infinity of this. same as z. X plus minus 1. Y plus minus 1. What we are just doing.
Should I erase? Can I do the same? Move something to the picture relative.
This one to be X, and this one Y.
I think that first we want to understand the complement.
Yes, first the complement.
So when so there is this union from the previous example, you still want to add subsectors, right?
Yes.
Well, have this inner cube.
Yeah, this one.
And
it should be like.
So throw it.
Then this T is this two knots without this ten. Yes.
T.
I mean, it should be like okay, Taurus. Okay. Also, in this, where is the but this tube should be not enough, right?
No, where? No. The picture again is the same. The tube.
Uh-huh.
So we have a picture of this T, right?
Yeah.
Yes, you can say that this hole is not. Yes.
This one, this, yeah, yeah.
On the other hand, you can draw a simple unknotted hole and glue to it the knotted hole. Just like we did here, we glue the knotted hole to the exterior of the thick torus.
Uh-huh.
And now we glue the knotted hole to the interior of the mark.
But should we have now like another hole in a torus and then glue?
Maybe you can draw?
No, I can't draw anything, but.
Yeah, I mean, well, okay, let's draw this in the same. in this one is where we are doing this one.
Yes.
But I don't know how it looks. Like, I cannot draw it.
So you need to answer animals, right?
Which
will do rather than not at home?
But there was not much choice.
Just this.
Yeah.
So this is another animals. So doing good another not at home, not with single eight. You can really see that. Just think, imagine that the figure eight is small. Yes, then this is what happens.
So here, it doesn't hold. But not here. Okay,
now we can look at the universal abelian curve.
So in this case, we will have something similar, but now we have where's the other one?
Well, it's on the other side.
Yeah.
It's in minus one. Right.
It is in. So yeah, we have the same here. This one.
We just have horizontal strips on the one side and vertical strips on the other side.
So maybe you just draw them.
Yes, I mean we have this just like in the previous example, and now we have like this. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But the green ones are on one side and blue ones on the other side.
Yes. So maybe.
This one. There are blue ones and green ones.
Probably glue some of these other boxes.
So we glue the noted holes of the first kind to the green strips and noted holes of the second kind to the blue strips. I mean the universal cover, the infinite secret covers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and just by my victorious, we get the answer.
Yes, so it's one can also try to draw it, yes, that we do whatever it is, H in that. Copies of HD here. then we have this sum for the bottom part and a similar sum for the top part, but now with products of this. Yes, and then a similar computation gives you this answer.
And topologically, it is something stage, the current.
Just this picture.
Yes.
So I think now we prove that if we have a two component plane, then it's Alexander module H delta sum.
For a two component link of a very special kind, which is the link together with two components.
Yeah. Okay.
But what is the example of link which is not of this kind?
The next example will not have this kind. Yes.
So we will consider the next example more complicated, and then we will compute all just the same exercise for more complicated things.
Yes, that's it for today. One more example.
And it will be next time. Yes.
No, just finish with one more example.
Today we will not take some other example. Just
with
this.
Let's do it today, and next time we will do some more.
I see my.
Or some
point. No, so next time we will try to see how to compute the Alexander module for two component links in general.
Okay. And what's the last example for today?
Well, either maybe we try to do the if you can do this link with link number 2, can you do it? Or we'll have to do it together.
Yeah, I don't think so. Yeah.
So choose one which is easier for you.
Yeah,
I think. And the
general
case also
is maybe.
Okay,
that's
this one.
Yeah.
What is the case?
Yes.
This is not
the
other example.
Now we can use the idea of personal couch to consider intermediate covering.
Yeah. That's what
we need to use. Along one component.
So in here, what we do is to I'm picking my words. So I basically construct the covering. Yeah, covering.
For the tree or not?
Yeah.
The complement of the tree or not?
Yeah. And and inside it should have like infinite copies of this. So it would look like
like a collection of hop link, infinite collection of.
Yes, exactly.
Inside a solid tube, yes, inside.
Inside the, yeah.
The problem is basically now that we're not allowed to take the torus, yes? Because these two are somehow quite detangled, so we're not able to say that this is a torus, yeah? From the,
yeah, there is no torus before the previous account.
Yes.
No torus.
And this is the cyclic coming of what? Of this one or of this one?
Probably easy to see this cyclic cover from the first, from the simple, from the simple, because just evidently we have such a picture. But in fact, we can prove that the same for.
In fact, the white link is symmetric. You can exchange components,
but geometrically, it is not so.
Yes, but if you just draw this component separately, this, or maybe you can just use colors. Let's call this one red. Look at it separately. And its complement is so that's 3 minus 3 of logs is that's 1 times 1, yes? The infinite secret cover of it is 1 or maybe it's better to call it
D2,
yes, so this will be R times D2, and this is the picture of R times D2. Okay? So, how to see that you really have this picture? We need to have, so actually here there is a disk, which is a separate surface for a streaming component, and we cut this complement along this disk, and you can see that here this is just one copy of this complement, and this is another copy of this complement, and they are glued together like they should be.
Now I think I don't want to use the word slice. I don't know how to.
What we will get the second covering, more complicated. Or just algebraic calculation without geometry, the second step of the construction.
The second step is actually similar to what we did before the break. We drew a Seifert surface on a symphony link.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we cut this picture along the Seifert surface. Of the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
But this Seifert surface must be erotic.
Yes.
Ignored than
yes,
the
no.
T action.
So, here. It will be our A. And this one will be
So we're applying all the same procedure once again, yes?
Yes.
But we are not afraid of the fact that the link is instantly discountably many.
No, not afraid.
Okay.
So we have this complement of this infinite link and this infinite tube. Yes, and we then have the infinite secret cover of this complement.
And we have to compute homology of this Z surface, lambda x model, yes?
Yes.
And how, and what's the answer? There are two generators?
Yes.
One generator.
Only one.
Huh?
Will be alpha.
This is for alpha each of the contour.
Yes.
But the Seifert surface, the homology of the Seifert surface is generated by just A. Yes.
That
module. Yes.
And look
so
what
we'll look at the homology of the Seifert.
How it looks like A?
So
just
as
just on the picture.
So the homology of the Z surface on a nose is infinite dimensional, yes? But as the module of a lambda,
as a module.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, sorry, I'm just, yeah. I don't see this on the board, and that's why I said.
And A with TA have one intersection point on. Or how many points? A and T A.
No, they don't. I mean.
Well, there are yes. On the separate surface have no intersection.
Yeah, they have no intersection.
But this is strange because we have duality in the homology group. Even we have take infinite covering. It could be intersection form, I guess, because without intersection form,
I think they should have intersection. Yes,
they should have. Yes,
they should intersect in one point.
Where that?
No. Two copies of green.
Two of what?
Of the green one. Okay, A and T A.
There are these two green ones, yes, and we want to understand, so here they
are. They are switch, and then they switch again.
So no intersection. This is A, and this is TA. But again, this is A, and this is TA.
So theoretically they don't intersect, yes? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Yes, so they are linked, but they don't intersect.
Is that possible?
Strange.
What, even the two girls on the surface linked but not intersect each other?
The second probably is B, which is just a segment we have not on the picture. Dual to A. What the cycle is dual to A? It's just a segment which is with the boundary on our link, yes? The cycle dual to A is not the picture, it's not required.
No.
Mm-hmm. And used to be it was required because we have to take basis on homology. And here we just have some collection of cycles which is not a basis. But the boundary is not connected, and so this is not a straightforward generalization of the previous construction, because in the previous construction we have first basis on homology on the FS surface, then we take the basis on homology on complement and take some algebraic relation, and here we have only basis.
So you can assume that this ciphered surface doesn't have boundary. It goes like this. It wraps along this tube.
But the link, the circle is on the boundary.
So I think we also have this. This should also be a generator. You can assume that it. One way to understand this picture is that the ciphered surface has boundary here and here.
But many other components of the boundary inside.
Yes, and also here and here. Yes. But
inside this is connected component of the boundary. I guess disconnected or is connected. How many components inside?
Each. So here we have a link of infinitely many components. And
so
each component is a component of the boundary.
Great.
But also there is additional
two additional components
of the boundary.
No, this can be glued together.
Can be glued together.
Yes, this is clear. But what about
interior? It seems that this gives you an additional cycle. So how yes. about this cycle? Is it expressible in terms of translates of A?
And not only one cycle, but collection of cycle over T, yes? There are infinite collection of cycles.
Yes, also
and this is dual collection to the A cycle, I guess.
It seems, mm-hmm. Yes.
Now it's more clear because if we take the base over lambda model, just we take just the same, but with A and B, because B is strongly required.
But actually, only one of them is needed, because the difference of these two, if you subtract this from this, it is minus A.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So only one of them is really needed.
Mm-hmm. So this is an extra relation which is geometrically eliminated. To take A is just we have to take all bases, but geometrically evidently that we can take only A collection of cycle because B is over lambda. There are relation between A collection and B collection. Yes, just Sergei Alexandrovich explain us that A cycle is just the difference between B and BT, as this I understood.
I think it is because
And linking number b minus bt is trivial, so it is possible algebraically. No, algebraically it is.
This is a little bit strange. So in the picture which we had in the end of the previous part, to compute the Seifert surface for the trifold, we had a similar picture. So there was a big picture here. There's two green curves. Mm-hmm. Yes? Mm-hmm. But these two green curves, which were bases of, also didn't intersect. Did they intersect?
But it has to be intersect. This
well,
is the pair. It has to be intersect.
We didn't pair, I think.
But I think they intersected.
This is just a whole complement.
This picture was a little bit different. So we had something like this.
Yes.
Three times. They really intersect because so we have only one piece. So if this goes here, then it appears here. And the other one, it comes, well, for example, it goes on this side, but then here it has to appear on this side. So there is an intersection. Maybe here there are two intersection points, no? No, don't make sense. How can we have a basis for a Seifert surface even if it's infinite without any self-intersections?
It's not possible. If you repeat step by step, you have to take all collection of cycle, not A, but probably only sub collection is strongly required, but I, for specialist, I think this is well known, but not so easy exercise. The last exercise is more complicated than the second one. The second one is more easy.
So we have an infinite strip, and then we group it rings. I want to draw the same picture in a different way. So here we have double twisting. Yes, and there is another like this. This is the same as
probably.
So how to find the basis in the homology of this?
There are two cycles. One side, relative homology is just one is A and B is just a segment, I guess. And segment can be.
But I think it's true. There are really just this. Well, we can draw a different basis. We can just choose these cycles, and actually that's all. We don't have any cycle here.
Yeah, because there are several components, and the cycle which is dual to this collection is relative cycle, and relative cycle will not contribute to this Alexander normal. It used to be it was not relative cycle, and here we have a collection of it, and there are not required.
Yes, so it is possible that for infinite surface we will have a basis without any.
Yes, because many components. Yes, it's possible.
Mm-hmm.
many components of what of boundary? Many components.
Many components of boundary. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How many components? Boundary components.
Each fragment give us a component, I guess.
So it seems this picture is actually right. We don't have this red cycle if we understand it as a surface with boundary.
Mm-hmm.
And then these green cycles give us all homology. They give us all generators. In homology, they don't intersect. So actually, mm-hmm. everything is correct.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now we consider again any plus and any minus. So we look
maybe you can just tell us the answer. Because we have seen one example.
Yeah, okay. And then we just use the relation of T.
No, this is in where it's changed. Maybe alpha minus T alpha.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sorry. Yes.
Okay, so A plus is alpha minus T alpha. Yes?
Yes.
Alpha minus T alpha. And this one is also.
Okay. So we use the relation that we used before. Well, it's not a T anymore, it should be something else.
Yes.
S. Yeah. So we have and we get this alpha.
Plus minus one.
Yes. And as for the general case, when we have more crossings here, which are going to be KL, we will get L times here. The alphas. So the general case just adds an L here. Like we have L here and L here.
Okay.
I think this is clear.
All right.
Yeah.
So, as you know, that the matrix is 2 by 1. Right?
Yes.
Okay. And what is the multivariate assembly polynomial?
Probably this is product. One minus two times one minus seven. But we can try to understand it. So it should be the greatest common divisor of all minors. So 2 by 1 matrix, it should have 1 by 1 minors.
Yeah.
Can you write it down the matrix? Why do we have 2 by 1? Isn't it 1 by 1? We have one generator.
Mm-hmm.
And one
relation.
That's what the GNS are
Well, they are generators of the ring. They are in the ring, but in the module, we have one generator off and one relation.
Yes.
Yeah.
So if we speak about the link, then we have the module over. Over longitude.
Two variables.
Yeah, so in this setting, there are two generators.
Why?
Yeah.
I think so we should have.
In general, we don't care about this intermediate step, yes? In general, if we just have a module over. Lambda 2, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So as this module over lambda 2, we have two generators.
Why? Which ones?
DNS. No?
No, alpha. Well, more precise the alpha 2 then. Mm-hmm. Because like before, which yes. So it's one of the leads to this infinite color.
Mm-hmm.
In this infinite cyclic covering, we have translations by T and translations by S. Translations by T go in this direction, just like in this picture, and translations by S go in this additional direction.
Yeah, wrong.
So we have one generator alpha tilde, and then it is translated by T and S, which gives you
I'm wrong.
Z plus Z additive generator.
So we have one generator and one
relation. Yes. So it's a 1 by 1 matrix, and in this case we just take its determinant.
Okay.
So in general, we are supposed to, if we have some matrix, yes, we are supposed to look at all the minors. So it's maybe R by S, a matrix where S is greater than R, then we look at all R by R minors and take their greatest common divisor, I believe.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's finish. Any questions? No questions. Okay.